Welcome to the Stairs segment video for the Bachelor View project. In this video, I'll cover placing both U and L-shaped stairs. I'll place the walls underneath, on top, and then a half-height wall with the stairs. I'll form a stairwell and then create a head height diagram in detail. To begin with, I'm going to change my plan view back to the floor plan shell, the variation without the dimensions. Then I'm going to come up and I'm going to use the camera, the perspective floor overview camera. And here's what I want to do. On this first floor, I want to form the stairwell that will go down to the floor below. The way stairs work in Chief Architect, it's best to place them on the floor below and have them go up to the next level. Using the floor indicator, let's go ahead and go down to the floor below. And this is where I want to place the stairs, is right in this region. Let's move back over into the floor plan view and talk about our stair tools. The draw stairs allow you to draw a few stairs. The straight stairs, when you click and place those, will automatically reach the different platforms. There's a variation to curve them. Then we have L and U-shaped stairs. As I go down to floor 0, let's go ahead and begin the process with our L-shaped stairs. As the stair dialog opens before we place them, it's going to ask you for the if you'd like to place them clockwise or counterclockwise, and if you'd like to make winders. Let's just accept the defaults for the time being. And now you'll get a ghost outline before you click and place the stairs. You can move your mouse to one side or the other before you left click, and it will automatically place those stairs. Now, one of the things that I notice is this won't be an ideal set of stairs for this design as we go up to the floor above. I'll go ahead and toggle on my reference display. You'll find a shortcut off to the far right-hand side of my screen. When I toggle on this reference display, it allows me, in this case, to see the floor below. As you notice, the stairs are coming up. This really won't work out well because we won't have much of a landing area. Well, let's go back down to the floor below. And I'm going to go ahead and delete these stairs and place a set of U-shaped stairs in here. So using the U-shaped stair, let's take a look at the dialog in this case. It's asking for a gap of 6 inches and also to split the landing. I'm going to tighten up that gap just a little bit. I'm going to make it a 4-inch gap in between the U stairs. And let's go ahead and figure out how we want to place these stairs. Again, by moving the mouse around or maybe even holding the Alt key down, you can also control which way these stairs are going to go and which is your best location. Once you see the ghost outline of those, I'm going to go ahead and click the left mouse button. Now let's go and take a look at our 3D view by clicking on the tab up here. And you can see how those stairs, I've got my default stair set up to have an open riser and a different panel shape, also to have a fairly thick tread in here. Now, one of the things that you may do with your stairs is you may have them enclosed by walls to form a stairwell, or you may have a wall that goes underneath the stairs. Let's look at a few of these different conditions, and I'm going to tile my screen here. I'm going to come up to my window, and I'm just going to tile my screen. I'm going to begin the process by drawing a wall underneath of the stairs, and when a wall is underneath of the stairs, it will actually clip that wall. Using an interior wall, I'm just going to come over here and draw it underneath of the stairs, and you're going to notice that it automatically cuts that wall off as it is drawn. Let's go ahead and tap on that wall, and I'm just going to slide it over just a little bit by nudging it. Now, using my arrow keys, I nudged it, and in this case, when you have a wall underneath stairs, you're probably not going to want to have an open riser in this case. I'm going to open up this lower segment by holding the Shift key down and just making a change on the lower segment. On the Style panel inside the stair dialog, you'll find the option to remove the open risers. Every time you make a change to your stairs, you'll see a preview update of the effect that those changes have on your stairs. There are several options you can control for your stairs. If we just look at a few, your stringer control, trim against wall, break line, you can control if it has a break line, also how it may be displayed on the current floor or the floor above, railing control, newels and balusters. Currently, I have it set up to be using a panel, and that's why you see the panel for the side railing. And on the rails itself, you can control the profile of it. And there are several other options down below here. Also on the general panel, you can control the tread information. If you remove the automatic setting, lock tread depth, you can come down here and actually control the treads. If I remove the automatic height, my dialog will jump around a little bit. You can control the details of your heights. Be a little careful there because you can create different stair segments. Remember, I have two sets of stairs with this U-stair, so I usually leave these automatic heights on. And there's also control to lock the top and bottom. Now that we've made the change to the stair riser, let's close this dialog. And now you can see that this looks a little more realistic for having a wall underneath of the stairs. Now when you select the wall, go ahead and press the tab key to get to the next object. And I slide this out just past the stairs. What happens is it will become a full height wall. As we rotate around a little bit, you can see that the railing is also turned off once that wall bumps up against that stair. That's an option. You can open up the stairs and force the railing on. Now there's one more style of wall that you can use that's called a... Now to make this a half height wall with a railing on top, let's go ahead and select it, open up the properties of the wall. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to mark that it's a railing. Then I'm going to come over to the wall types and I'm going to mark that it's a pony wall. And on the lower section of the wall, and it's an interior 4, I'm going to reduce that height to 12 inches. And then on the upper wall type, let's go ahead and change that to an interior railing. And then I'm going to come over to the rail style. There's an option down here in the bottom that indicates that you want it to follow the stairs. Let's go ahead and mark that. And now you can see this railing is following the stairs. And if we click on this wall, pull it down just a little bit further, it will actually remove that railing if you pull it about to the midpoint of that last tread. That's how you can place a variety of different walls. Now one of the things that we can do for the stairs is to form an auto stairwell. On this lower floor in the 3D view, if I actually go up a level and look, I currently don't have a stairwell. One of the tools you can use in your 3D is called the glasshouse view, and you can actually see the wireframe and see where those stairs are. Now what you can do to create an automatic stairwell, go back down to this floor so I can select the stairs, and there's a tool in the lower edit menu that will automatically create the stairwell for you. Notice it disappears after you select that tool. Let's go back up to the floor above, and now you're going to see the stairwell has automatically been created. Let me toggle on my standard view. And you can see the automatic stairwell that was formed, including the opening. And I'll probably make a slight adjustment to this opening. It's considered just a doorway. And I'm just going to slide that over until it aligns. And now you can see the way that that stairway has been formed. One of the things that will be important as you place stairs in a design is to make sure you have the headroom clearance. I'm going to take a section view through here. And let's confirm that, in fact, we do have our headroom clearance. Back into the floor plan view, one of the section tools that we have available to us is one of them called the back clip cross section. This will create a slice depending on how far you click and drag your camera. Using this back clip cross section camera, I'm going to come through and just create a slice right through this section of the stairs. Now you can see that our headroom area is going to be right in here where the stairs come down, the floor platform protrudes, and what I want to do is make sure that I meet the minimum code. Here's how I'm going to do that. I'm actually going to just use a line tool, and I'm going to draw a line right down in this area right here, and then I'm going to also draw another line that will represent where that will intersect on the nosing of the stair tread. So I've just snapped a couple of lines in there. Using my dimension tool, I'm going to use the end-to-end dimension. I'm going to come over here onto the floor platform, click and drag until we hit that line. zoom in a little bit, make sure that I actually get the ceiling finish of that lower area. And then for this line, I'm going to highlight it. I'm going to mouse over the dimension. I'm going to type in 80 inches for the minimum area that I'd like to make sure. Let's go ahead and pull this line up on the nosing of the tread up a few more stairs. We'll have plenty of headroom. Where this line intersects the other line is where I'm going to have 6'8" of headroom. And if I were to draw just another dimension using the tape measure, you can see that I've got at least 4'8" to clear that, and if I wanted to bring that floor platform back in this area, I would have plenty of room. Now you're going to find a number of CAD details in the program that you can augment your design. Let's go ahead and open up our library catalog. And one of the things you're going to find are several CAD details that you can use. You can unblock them and you can customize them. You see a preview of this. If you were to search for an interior stair detail, and then I can right click and say show in browser, that's going to open up where that detail is. If I scroll down, that's actually one of our bonus catalogs. You can go out and get additional content and download that. You can place these details. I'm just going to place it off to the side over here. This detail can be unblocked and customized if you just use the unblock button. It can be customized for your locale and what your building department may require to create your details. Now, as I open up my completed layout sheet for this plan, you can see that my section view in the upper right area, I've created a complete section view of the structure. And then here on the following page, in the lower right hand corner, you can see that I've created another section. I've added a stair detail similar to the one you saw in the library, and then I placed my stair notes as well in that section view. Well, that concludes this video segment on stairs for the Bachelor View project.